For the beginning of your governorship, you were talking about having a redistricting commission to really look at how we draw congressional districts and that type of thing, legislative districts, because of the gerrymandering. I mean, it's been recognized. Maryland's congressional map is the most gerrymandered map in the nation by independent entities. They've recognized that. There's legislation that was killed yesterday in the House of Delegates, correct, when it came to your redistricting commission bill.
Well, it's really unfortunate and disappointing and outrageous because an overwhelming majority of Marylanders from both parties, from all parties, strongly support nonpartisan independent redistricting. And our bill would do just that. It would take the drawing of district lines away from the politicians and take the politics out of it and just draw fair districts so that we could actually have free and fair elections in Maryland and the competition of a healthy and competitive two-party system. And it would allow for, you know, for citizens to actually select their lawmakers rather than the other way around. And right now they're just picking their constituents. We do have the worst, most gerrymandered districts in the country. And
but I want people to understand, according to independent entities that did not Republican or Democrat,
right,
but nonpartisan entities that judge these things.
Well, and supporting our bill are all of the, what you would think of as left-leaning Democratic organizations, you know, Common Cause and the League of Women Voters and Public Citizen and all of those groups, along with Republicans and Democrats all over the board, supported. It's been, you know, editorialized and endorsed by the Baltimore Sun and Washington Post. And there's almost no one in Maryland who wouldn't like to see free and fair elections and fair districts.
And by the way, there are very few governors that would actually give up power as
yeah,
what this bill
is.
This
is my power because I believe I'm going to be the governor in 2020 when we redraw the districts. But I just believe that it's a fair way to do it. And I've been calling for at least an up or down vote on the floor of the House and the Senate for 2 years. And they kept putting this thing in the drawer, never bringing it up. And we got very close to bringing it to the floor yesterday. And in a kind of sneaky maneuver, the Speaker of the House had the committee immediately pulled together and voted it down on a party line basis. So 18 Democrats killed the opportunity for all of the other legislators to have a chance to vote on it.